Well, the good news is we've come to the last chapter in the book, and the second part of good news is this is actually a very easy concept. We're going to be talking about goodness of fit tests. And the symbol is the x square. Actually, it is the Greek symbol chi. We actually call that chi square. We use this for categorical choices, and the purpose of this is to compare the amount in each category that we observe with what we expected to observe. In other words, maybe we thought there was no preference between Coke and Pepsi, and if we observed that there was a difference, we wanted to see whether or not this is statistically significant. And this will make more sense as we continue on in this slideshow. Again, the purpose of the goodness of fit test is to compare what we observed with what we expected. And so we're going to use F sub 0 as the frequency observed and F sub E as the frequency that we expected. And so our null hypothesis will be that there's no difference between the observed and the expected outcomes or frequencies. The alternate is that there is actually a difference. Now, we'll have an example in the textbook, but let's just start with a very simple example here. Let's assume I had a class, a live class in front of me, and I was wanting to survey whether or not there was a difference in which the students preferred. So I'm going to, you know, ask for a show of hands, how many of you prefer McDonald's, how many of you prefer Wendy's, how many of you prefer Burger King. And so my sample results might be that 11 preferred Wendy's and 12 preferred Burger King and 10 preferred McDonald's. Well, if there is no difference, my frequency expected is actually going to be the 33 divided by 3. There's three categories, there's 33 total, so I would have expected 11 for each one, and that isn't exactly what I've got. So what I'm going to use is the goodness of fit test, the chi-square, to see if there is a statistically significant difference at the 0.05 significance level or whatever significance level I choose to determine that, yes, indeed, there is a preference. In other words, the null hypothesis, there is no preference. The alternate, there is a preference or there is a difference in the observed versus expected frequencies. Well, here you see the formula to compute the chi-square. It's actually pretty simple. The first thing you're going to do is you're going to take the difference between the frequency that you observed and the frequency that you expected. You'll square that. You'll divide that by the frequency expected. Of course, you'll take the absolute value of that, and you'll sum it up. Again, very, very easy to do when you're looking up a critical value, and we'll talk about how to do that as we go further here. We're going to be using the degrees of freedom of k minus 1, where k is the number of categories. So with my example of the fast foods, k would be 3, three different fast food restaurants, and the degrees of freedoms would be k minus 1 or 2. All right, so let's go through a complete example in the book here. So Bubba's Fish and Pasta, the owner thinks that there is no preference of the people who prefer chicken, fish, meat, or pasta. And so he took a sample, and the frequency that he observed is as follows: chicken 32, fish 24, meat 25, and pasta 29. So we want to see whether or not there is a statistically significant preference between the four entrees here. Now we're still doing hypothesis testing here, so we're still going to use the five steps. So step number one is to state the null and the alternate hypothesis. The null hypothesis is there is no difference between what we observed and what we should have observed or expected to observe. The alternate is that there is a difference. Then we're going to state the level of significance, so we're going to choose 0.05, and then we're going to choose the test statistic, but because this is a difference between what we're observing and what we're expecting to observe in categorical data, we're obviously going to use the chi-square. Remember that degrees of freedom are k minus 1, and there were four categories or four different kinds of entrees. So the degrees of freedom is 3, and chi-square is just a one-tail test. So we then look up a critical value. We find a critical value with the degrees of freedom of 3 and the 0.05 significance level of 7.815. So that's the critical value that we're going to compare what we compute to. And here's the chart or diagram that you should be quite familiar with at this point. This is not a normal distribution because it is just one tail. But again, we have the critical value of 7.815, the rejection region there. So we're going to compare what we compute to the critical value, and if it is greater than the critical value, we will reject the null hypothesis. All right, so here's how we actually compute the chi-square. We take the frequency observed and the frequency expected. We subtract the one from the other. We square them. And then finally, we take that square divided by the frequency observed, sum it up. And once it's summed up, we end up with a chi-square of 2.2. And after we have computed the chi-square, we're going to compare that to the critical value to determine whether we should reject or not reject the null hypothesis. All right, so using the graph to compare the critical value to the chi-square that we computed, we can see that it is in the do not reject. So therefore, we are going to conclude that even though we saw some minor differences in the preferences to the 0.05 significance level, we cannot conclude that there is a significant difference. Chi-square is one of those things that is not available in data analysis in Excel. There is a chi-square test function in Excel, but it does not actually give you the value of chi-square. It actually computes the probability. And so we can see that with the chi-square test, as you see in the slide here, it computed a probability of 0.3. Well, that is a much higher probability or far greater than 0.05. So using the p-level, we would also not reject the null hypothesis because it is not smaller than the 0.05 p-level or probability that we were looking for.